first installment of the Speed of Sound, the program for and about the local music scene. Each month, I'll introduce you to new bands and other aspects of the Chicago and Aurora area music underground. This month, you'll meet two Aurora bands, local favorite Shadow's Edge and Lockin. So if you're going to waste your life sitting in front of the television, just watch this program. We'll be back right after this.
This is Alec Baldwin, thanking you for giving to United Way. Because when you gave, you helped Deborah Kinney get emergency shelter, provided a senior daycare center for Mary.
Welcome back. I'm Derek, and this is the Speed of Sound. Each month, I'll be bringing you new music, so if you like what you see or hear, at the end of the show, I'll have a mailing address where you can send any comments or demos if you have a band and are interested in appearing on the show. But for now, let me introduce you to Shadow's Edge.
Possibly a speed metal, you could say, or you could just, you know, because people say we sound kind of like a Testament, Megadeth, Metallica. So Megadeth's been labeled as speed metal, and Metallica I've always considered heavy metal, and I've heard people call Testament like a thrash. Whether all those labels are true, I don't know, but. So I would just consider metal.
If anything, you would compare it to more like Megadeth or Metallica, you know. And our music, basically, I mean, our influences are more like Spread Eagle, Dangerous Toy. Those are our main influences, but we were able to play heavy metal the best, you know. It was what we could do better than any other style of music, so. But I think we got our own style too, so. We'll see what happens, you know, what people think.
We're not like a thrash band. We're more along the lines of like Metallica or Megadeth or, you know, something like that. A lot of people think that we're thrash, but we're not. You know, we're just metal with a twist, I guess.
And we're trying to get to play out maybe at least once a week, but lately we've been doing like maybe twice a week for a couple weeks, and then we'll break, have a break for a couple weeks, and then do another two each week. So we try to get out of town. We just don't want to play too much in our own area so that people don't get tired of it. You know, so they'll get, you know, want to, you know, just come check us out. But if they see me too many times, they're just like, well, they'll be here next week, you know, we want people to look forward to check us out.
A lot of times, you know, if you're not a well-known band, it's hard to get people to come to your show. You know, some shows will be not so good, and other ones will be really good. You know, where we'll have a lot of people.
We usually play out. We've been playing out about almost a show a week, almost. We just did a show on the weekend, which was two shows in a week. But normally we do at least two shows a month, you know, for sure, usually.
Aurora is a lot funner because of the fact that we know so many, you know, in our town. But Chicago is a little more colder. The fans don't come up to you and, you know, hey, you guys are great. You may get a few, but usually they'll keep to themselves, and then you'll see them later on at your show. But in Aurora, everybody's, yeah, it's a lot more. I think it's a lot more.
Man will have a
brain, I just want you to know that I know what you're thinking. And you're thinking about the speed of sound here on Aurora Community Television. I'm Scott Loftus from Y108. Think about the speed of sound. It's not as fast as the speed of light, but it is very fast. And it's illegal in most metropolitan areas because of sonic booms. But you're watching here on Community Television in Aurora, the land of wind and dark. And make sure you rock out on Y108, too. Yeah!
They've always known what was going to happen. It was inevitable that I was going to, you know, jam in a band. I didn't expect this much support from the, you know, I didn't know how we were going to sound. We just kind of came out and did our thing, you know. Luckily, everybody digs it, so we get supported pretty much. I haven't had any criticism too much.
My friends, 100%, they're all behind me. My family. they wish me luck. That's about it. They're not into the whole idea and necessarily behind me on it, but they wish me, if that's what I'm gonna do, you know, to do it and be happy with it.
My friends, everybody likes band, you know, what we're doing. My family, you know, some of them think, well, it's just like a phase, I guess, he's going through, or, you know, a couple of them came to our shows, but, they don't really show support, you know, outwardly. I don't know what they really think, you know, I've never really asked them.
They're buying tapes, you know, supporting us all the way, so, it seems that basically this is what we want to do, and they're not going to help us, you know, we're supposed to do. So, yeah, I got all my support in my family. In fact, they're playing my house, so my mom listens to the racket 3 times a week, you know, so that's got to be supported.
You know, a lot of bands just stay stagnant, you know. We want to try and take it as far as we can, and, you know, eventually get on a record label. You know, stop having to work all the time for a living, you know, just write music.
We want to take it all the way, you know. I mean, we want to play Alpine Valley, Rosemont, you know, fucking Moscow Peace Festival, whatever, you know, I don't care. It's just anything big, you know, would be exciting. So as far as our music will take us, it's where we're going.
I don't have anything else in my life, man. This is it. This is what I'm doing, you know. I mean, this is all I know how to do. You know, I could never work 9 to 5. It's just not my style. People like Pat, you know, they could always go resort to their job full time and make probably good money, but yeah, unfortunately I don't have that, so I don't have a choice, but I don't want to have a choice. I would rather know the do or die situation. If I don't make it, I don't make it. Make it win.
Right when we got our equipment, we decided, you know, it was like, this is what we're going to do, you know, and we've always had that attitude. I mean, even when we were kids, we always wanted to be in a band. Always. It's not something that, you know, ever slipped our mind. It's always been what we wanted to do. And we're going to take this as far as we'll take it. I mean, you know, no matter what, if we tried to put down our instruments and just say, well, we're not going to do this anymore, it wouldn't work. You know, we would still be screwing around with our instruments, you know, if not forming a new band right away, you know. So, yeah, as far as this will take us, you know, unless we just get burned out or something, but I can't imagine that happening. It's all we think about and do. That's all we like doing. It's all we look forward to. So we'll see what happens.
Well, now that you had a chance to meet Shadow's Edge and hear them live, it's time for the premiere of their first video. This is The Cause of Corruption. That was the premiere of The Cause of Corruption, the first video from Shadow's Edge. I want to thank everybody who helped me on the first show. I had a blast doing this, and thank you for watching. And now here's a quick preview of Lock It, another Aurora band who will be on an upcoming show. Until next time, laters.